Hi everyone, it's the Comic Fan Man here, coming at you with a new video. And in today's video, I have a very, very special unboxing. This is the third Christmas present that I got this year. And I have to say, I am so happy. I'm so looking forward to this. And I think this will wash away all the bad taste in my mouth that I had of the Mayfix Batman v Superman Batman figure bootleg that I got, that I had no idea was a bootleg. This is the Maestro Union's Weng, the Blade Master from the FuRay Planet series. This is an independent figure, a very, very high-end figure. I believe this is the third one in the series. The first two was a crocodile and a werewolf, which I didn't like, so I never bothered with those. But as soon as I saw this design, I was like, wow, I really want that. But then I saw that it was a $90 figure, and that's kind of, I don't want to spend that kind of money on these, on the high-end figures. I just, you know, for me, it's just too much money. I am a family man. And there are plenty of figures that come out that are really great that are not that expensive. So I was like, I'm going to have to pass on this. But it did come out on Amazon, and I had a discount that was due to me for Amazon, a 10% discount. And they already had discounted it down to $89 from the $96. And then I also realized that because I use my personal credit card for all of my Amazon shopping, I had a bunch of credit card points that I could put toward my next purchase. So I did that, and I got this figure, a $90 figure. I got this for $30. I used all of my credit card points and the discount, and it brought the price down to $30, which is exactly where I kind of draw the limit as far as pricing for figures that I'm going to purchase if I really, really like them. I try to stay within the $20 to $30 range. That, for me, that's okay. I can spend that much. Anything more than that, I kind of like, it's too much. And then especially the $90 and above figures, I definitely don't normally buy those. But here we are. This is beautiful box art. Let's just take a quick look at all of this box art. It has a very beautiful pen and ink Asian look to it. I love this. It's got a lot of Asian calligraphy on the side. And look at that beautiful painting of Blade Master Weng on the side there. Looks magnificent. And here's another painting that's really gorgeous, along with the two ways that you can have them. Actually, there's a third way, because I'll show you later. You can actually take this off, and you could just have him in his him and just his pants, which kind of helps a lot with the articulation. This side is just a scratch marks and the FuRay Planet logo. So I can't wait to open this up. I did hear that this figure, if you want to do any swapping out, that you have to do some heating up. So I'm going to take this out the box, put out all the accessories, heat up the figure, and we'll get going with this figure review. All right, give me a few minutes and I'll be right back. All right, so here he is out of the box with all of his crazy amount of accessories. Blade Master Weng. I did it this way first because I wanted to strip everything off so that I can show you his articulation. His articulation is excellent, very, very good, but only without all of the extra armor. But as you can see, once you strip him down, you can put him in some, you know, serious karate poses, which is great. His articulation is really good. he's got butterfly joints on the shoulders and swivel, double jointed elbows, double jointed knees as well, which is nice. He's got articulation at his very beastly animal ankles. But as you can see, look at this crazy split, and he's standing perfectly. he's got the ball joint at the head, and the neck has its own little rotation. But take a look at that. He's great. Somebody strike up the Kung Fu fighting song. Let's go. It looks fantastic. Let's take a look at his paint apps, so that you can see. Look at this face. This face is amazing. His top knot too. Nice little top knot detail there. But take a look at the face. That's a really nice snarl. He does come with a second face sculpt. This one is just a more calm, wise, sage type face sculpt. I really do wish that he did have a animalistic roar face sculpt, but he doesn't. He just comes with this snarl. But he does still look ready for a fight. Look at all that beautiful paint applications that they did here with the tiger stripes and everything. This is amazing. And there's also some kind of dry brushing here, like some kind of gray. And it's definitely applied by hand because it's not all like one tone all over the place. It's a bunch of different tones. Some of the hands have more, some of them not so much. So it's really, really nice. Now, I'm about to go over his accessories, but the reason why I wanted to show you this with him stripped down is because I wanted to show you that all the places that are covered up, look at this on his leg. This is amazing. This is all covered up. He has these boots, these boot covers that go right over all of that, but they still went ahead and did tiger stripes all over the place, and the two-tone orange, brown, and white wash all over it. And you're not gonna see any of this because it's covered by the boots, but they did it anyway, and it still looks amazing. Take a look at his back. He's got the he's got the Yujiro Hanma demon back. This is amazing. This is about as anime as it gets, as far as muscle detail. And this thing is huge. He's absolutely massive. And he kind of makes me feel like he's a kung fu version of Shere Khan from The Jungle Book. Like, this is great. This is such an interesting figure. And I really, really wanted it. And it was just like, I knew I wasn't going to be able to get it because of the price point. But when I saw, like, all the discounts that I had on Amazon, you know, it just made it very easy to get this. Oh, and by the way, the reason I'm also counting this as a Christmas present is because for the last $30, my other cousin, Adrian, gave me a $30 Amazon gift card. So that covered the last $30 that I had to pay for this figure. So that was great. So I basically got this figure for free. I think I only paid like $2. But you know, as a $100 figure, I can definitely see why he was worth $100. This is amazing. So let's take a step back with the figure. Let's start going over his accessories. All right, the first accessory out of the box was this comic book. This is amazing. It's in a very Asian pen and ink and watercolor on rice paper type technique. and the rest of the comic is like that. Because this came from Amazon, it's actually in English, but the translation is really, really bad. So don't, I mean, I read it just to like get a feel for it, but really this was more about the artwork than anything else. The story is kind of silly. It kind of makes it look like all of these animals are in a bunch of different time frames all mashed into one, because there's like motorcycles, cars, but then there's samurai and ninja, mobsters. So it's a, yeah, you see like this is a mobster and a bike gang member. So it's covering like every time frame, every era. It's really cool. But again, don't worry about the translation. Just absorb the art. And it also has some, I think this is art from fans who submitted art, which is really cool. They might be professionals, I don't know, but it looks like fan art to me. And it's got some coming soon things, which I believe this is, looks like this is going to be Wukong. One is the, it looks like this is when he's the demon with the white hair, and then this is when he's got his golden hair. So I guess he was before the demon, and then this is the bull demon. So that's really cool. I don't know what this character is. It looks like a hyena, I guess. And a really nice splash page of Weng and a nice back cover. This was really good. It's about 40 to 50 pages of art, which is awesome. It all looks like Asian art, and I really, really love it. Now, let's take a look at the stuff that we have here, which is part of his actual armor. So this is the first thing, is his cape. It's a nice soft rubber. It's got some nice wash on the inside. It's pretty flexible. And on the outside, it's got some really, really nice wash that goes from dark to light, making it look kind of faded. There's a peg hole here, and this is what covers the peg hole. This little knot here fits right in there. There's a notch for it to fit a certain way. And I'll show you a picture of what it looks like with this knotted in there. I won't show you that here because I'm actually going to show you why this is open. Now, let's talk about his sash, his side guards. This is wonderful. Oh my goodness. This looks so amazing. This is all the red is super soft. The brown is a little harder, but it's also soft. The red is really soft though. And just take a look at all of this detail that they put in here. And all of this patina and washes that they put in here to make it look aged. This is amazing. This really looks like like an old warrior's waist guards. And take a look here. This is a translucent, I guess, jade type thing. That's really cool. They actually use translucent plastic to make it look like real jade, which is amazing. And it's got little holders here and here. And I'll show you what goes in there, but it has 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 5 little holders. And he's got a lot that goes on this little belt. So let's take a look at those accessories. Over here, he's got his smoking pipe. This is great. Take a look. Oh, let's take a look at this. It's a bamboo pipe with copper tips. Really, really nice. You see this little hook here? This little hook here is for his little tobacco bag. Take a look at this. He's got a little tobacco bag. and it goes right into this little hook right here. And there you go. He's got his smoking pipe with his tobacco. And this, the way it is, goes right into this loop right here. And there you go. He's got his little tobacco pipe. And then he's got these three little Naruto styled kunai, little throwing knives. Let's see if I can get a good picture of these. But these are very much in the style of Naruto. They look fantastic. One side is slightly more detailed than the other, so that's obviously the face. So let me show you how they go. One, two, and three. His three little kunai goes right next to his pipe. And then the last thing that goes on his utility belt is his gourd. This is his, I guess it would be like sake or wine or water gourd. This one goes on this loop right here. That's the back loop. That's his gourd. Now his utility belt has all of its things on it. That's great. I love this patina and shielding on there. That's so cool. And his, he's got chainmail hanging off of there. This is really amazing. Such an amazing detail. All the washes and painting that they did on this is really, really amazing. Okay, let's continue on. Now with his ninja scroll-esque bamboo cap. Now this is crazy. Look at all the detail. They made it look like real bamboo. There's a slash here, so you know there's some kind of story to this. On the box, he kind of like wears it to where like you can see one of his eyes peeking through there. It's done in amazing quality. I really love this. And it's interesting because this made me think that this was a Japanese style character, but it's not. This is a Chinese style character. And I'll get into, and I'll explain why, but this is not a, like a Ronin samurai. He's actually like, sort of like a Chinese sword master monk or of some kind. All right, so this is the straw hat. This is great. And now we'll go into the, these are the boots. He can change into these. You take out the tiger feet, you put these on. So when he's walking, obviously one is left, one is right. And again, the work that they did on this little thing is amazing. I don't know if you can, if it's picking it up properly, but there's some, there's a stitching pattern that goes through the boot. I hope my camera is picking it up properly. That looks really, really good. Yeah, and this just goes right on his feet. You take out the tiger feet, you put these on. Very good. And I think I already showed you this. This is the extra face sculpt that he has. It's just, you know, in serene mode here. Just very nice, very calm. And then this piece here, this is just to, like, when you take off the cape, this is to make it look like extra tiger fur around his neck. See, it'll sit like that, which is great. But the problem with this thing is that it kind of messes with his head articulation. So I kind of like not putting it on. But you know what? Here, let me just show you real quick. The head comes on and off real easy, which is nice. Because the hands and the feet do not. But that's what he looks like with the neck piece on. As you can see, it's just an extra tuft of fur to make him look like a full-on tiger neck. But again, this blocks a lot of his articulation, so I don't really see myself using that much. But it's there. And they give you this extra bit of twine here. This twine is supposed to go on the ends of his briefcase. Now, I won't show you the briefcase yet, and I don't think I'm gonna be using this. I might, but for right now, I don't see any use for this, so I'm not really gonna use this. And let's show all of his hands. These are his two sword gripping hands. They're fully painted. They have wash on them. This is really great. I love this. This was his more like clawing at hands. Again, fully painted with wash. This looks really, really astounding. I love it. All the nails and the fingernails are all very sharp. So yeah, so actually really be careful with this, because you'll, when you're putting them on and off, you could scratch yourself pretty nicely with that. And then he's got two balled up fisted hands for when he's, you know, having to punch somebody out. And again, even though they're balled up fisted hands, painted with a nice wash on them, bringing up all the details. This is amazing. I love this. The amount of detail and paint that they put on this figure is crazy. And these are the leg coverings, the ones that go over his shin, which I'll show you that once I put all of his stuff back on. They are marked, I don't know if you can see it, but they are marked left and right, so you know which legs to put these on, which is great. And again, a nice wash on the fur bottoms of these, a painted, like, you know, and washed to make it look like it's used leather. This is great. I love this. And then these are his arm guards. His arm guards are also really, really good. And they're also marked left and right, so you know which arms they go on. So that's his arm guards. And on his arm guards, I almost forgot about these. These are his bangles. These go on his arm guards. This is amazing. This is like the rings from Shang-Chi, or the laundromat man from Kung Fu Hustle. These are great. They're wonderful, and they're all individual, and they're all painted and patinaed individually. Like, wow. This company really did an amazing job with this. It's fantastic. So let me show you. This is how they go onto the gauntlets. It's just like that. Very simple. And now he has the Kung Fu, he'll have the Kung Fu Hustle rings on his arms when all is said and done, and they're loose and they move around, they click clack. It's really great. Just an amazing amount of detail and accessories that are on this thing. You know, just these arm guards with the six rings you're talking about, there's eight pieces to this. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28. 29, and then we have his carrying case. 30. Look at this thing. This is absolutely amazing. Look at all the paint washes on here. Look, it's got rings on the sides. This is where you tie the twine. Look at these corners, they're metallic and they have patina and they have sculpting. All the wood grain is sculpted. All the hinges are done nicely. All of this leafing and patina showing a little dragon in the middle. This is crazy amount of detail in just this one little piece. And look, even the hinge. The hinge has some patina and some detail. And now wait, once you open it, what do we have? The two Guandao style broadswords. Take a look at this. So this is 30, 31, 32 accessory pieces for this one figure. This is amazing. And this has a felt, like a wine felt holding for the swords. And now let's take one of the swords out so you can see all the detail that's on here. Box down. Look at this. This is absolutely amazing. There's an etched tiger on the blade itself. It's sculpted and scaled, painted. There's a nice wash. There's these two little rings. And then look at this hilt. The hilt is sculpted. It's got leaves and it's got a tiger head at the base of it. This is amazing. Let's get a closer look at all of this work. And this blade, this is a Guandao style blade. The reason I know that is from all the Three Kingdoms game. There's a character that has a Guandao pole arm, and this is the style of blade that's at the end of it. I am obviously not Chinese or Japanese, so I assumed this character was a samurai of from Japanese because of the straw hat and all. So I thought he was like a ronin, but because he comes with this Guandao style blade, this is a blade of a Chinese military soldier. So he's not a samurai. He would be a like a sword master monk of some kind. And simply because of this Chinese style blade made me realize he's actually a Chinese style character and not a Japanese samurai style character. This is great. Unbelievable. So, okay, we took a look at the tiger. We took a look at his articulation. We took a look at his accessories all separately. Let's put this man together and see how this traveling monk looks when he's going through New Eternia. Oh, I'm sorry. I did want to show one more thing before we put everything back on him. I did hear about the fact that changing his hands and feet are super hard to do because of the hinging system that they did. Yes, it is super duper hard. It's absolutely crazy. I don't know why they made it the way they did. This is gonna break at some point if you keep doing it that way. So here's a trick that I did. I did heat it up to take everything off at first, initially. And then what I did was I took this little paintbrush and I took some sandpaper, rolled it up really, really tight. And I went into all the peg holes and I sanded it just ever so slightly. And so now you can see, I can take the hands off and you can see what it's like after I sanded it. And let me find one of the other hands. I'm gonna put the one of the sword holding hands, and it fits right in and it comes right off without heating it. And I did that for the hands, and I also did that for the feet, for the wrist part right here, and I also did it for the feet part right here. The rest of the figure you should have no problems with. But yeah, I did have to sand out the articulation holes. Oh yes, and also as a side note, hey Mattel, take a look at this so that you can maybe do this for the Masterverse figures, because trying to change those shorts were an absolute crazy, crazy job. So here, take a look. Just take this, wiggle it, it pops right off. And look, now you got the legs all by themselves. And you can put his belt back on. You see, Mattel? It can be done. I don't know why you came up with that crazy system that caused so much problems. Do it this way. Just a ball joint. What's the issue? All right, so before I show him completely dudded up, this is the peg that goes into the peg hole. And the reason that's there is to hold his carrying case. You snap the peg in through here, make sure it stays nice and clicked, and there you go. Now it's part of the attachment. Let's put them together. All right, so here he is, fully geared up and ready to travel. Eternia's, new Eternia's traveling Kung Fu Monk Tiger. Again, this just looks so amazing. The aesthetic is so cool. This cape here is flexible enough that you can swing his arm forward without it hindering. And it just looks really amazing. You can put the swords in different positions. I love the fact that he has his pipe, the three kunai here, and his drinking gourd right there, and his carrying case in the back. Take a look. Oh man, this is crazy. And I did put the boots because he is traveling, so nobody likes walking on bare feet. However, I probably will be putting the tiger feet back on because I just love the way that they look. So, but I figured if I'm gonna make him look different, might as well do the whole thing. And this is him, and he stands perfect without any kind of peg stand or anything like that. He doesn't have any peg holes, and he stands perfect. His balance, however they designed this, the balance on this figure is amazing, even with everything on. He's top heavy, he's back heavy, but he doesn't fall over. It's really cool. And I'm trying to see if I can line up the slit to get the eye. You know, I'm wondering if you can see that. That's really cool. Get the eye through the slit there. This character is really heavy. He's really big. I mean, if you think about it, you know, the tigers, the Bengal tigers, they're all huge. They're, I believe they're the biggest cats. I believe they're bigger than lions. And so picture a Bengal tiger that learned Kung Fu. Like, what the hell? He's already big enough to destroy you as is, and now you give him martial arts skills and big Guandao style blades and forget about it. Like, you're gonna be mincemeat. I love this character. This is so cool. This is amazing. I can definitely see why he's so expensive. He's definitely seems to be worth every penny. But again, because I like to keep my channel affordable on figures that are affordable for the everyday, you know, collector, I tend not to get these style of figures. But I really, really, really wanted this. And I was bummed out when I saw the price point. But, you know, thanks to Amazon, thanks to my cousin, thanks to my credit card points, here he is. He is now in my collection. He's going to be a traveling monk. He's going to be very much, you know, for me and my storyline, he's going to be very much like a battle beast, where he doesn't care if you're good or bad. He just wants the best fight from you possible. And I really, really like this figure. This is, for me, this is obviously going to be in my top 10 of this 2024 year. I love this. These guys did an amazing job. And, you know, like I said, the first few figures that they did, I didn't get them because I didn't like those styles. I don't really like modern style warriors. I like these classic sword and sorcery martial arts style warriors. So if they make another one of these styles, you know, maybe for next year, if I got more credit card points and more Amazon discounts, I'll be able to get another one if they make one in this style. So if you enjoyed this look, please give me a like and subscribe. And please join me in our next video, which hopefully, you know, we'll be able to get back into Masterverse, because some of my figures are finally supposed to start coming in. So again, I hope you have a great new year. I hope you had a good time with your family, and I will see you in the next video. Thank you and have a great day. Bye-bye.
What are you doing here, my Castle Grayskull? Looking for a challenge, cat. Who are you calling a cat? Cat?
Do you see now, Groon, that when I summon the Thundercats, all cats must answer?
I answer no one. I am passing through. Pop.
Hey, too bad. Let's see what we can do against this guy. We'll take his swords, we'll take his case, we'll take his money, we'll take his pipe. Ha! You got it, Beast Man. Let's do it.
Hey. Hey, come back. Too bad I ain't done with you yet.
No challenge.